Vemprano's had a standout tournament. He's been absolutely fantastic. We've seen him doing everything that Rogue needs and more. The one that I want to really watch throughout this game, and everybody at home, keep your eye on as well, could be a
KDS, the first one to take some bullets in this matchup, but it's Alamau who strikes first. Alamau versus Aces. It's all coming up Alamau.
It's going to be a big battle as this one progresses. There's no two ways about that. Both influential players for their
key timing was coming up to provide support and has eaten a grenade to the chops in the process. So, down to three for a momentary second. Leon finding another one across onto Neskin. Two more coming in. Leon popping off there before one comes flying back the other way. Looking pretty good for Rogue. They've got 40 seconds to play with and they're locking down those flanks with the gridlock tracks.
Lagones with a really important kill there. Dez just stepping up onto White Stairs, taking down one of Rogue, but he's a smart player. He's not going to over-engage there. He dips away. He's got the heartbeat scanner. If he gets the chance for a couple of seconds, just to feed a bit of information into Levy, and it's now down to those two. 23 seconds left to go. They need to hold on. Levy is seriously low health there. A little unfortunate for Leon. Flashbang comes back off the side of the hatch. Lagonis finds Leon 2v2. They're doing it, Dez. Levy manages to find Rips. It's all up to Prano, the man of the moment. Shut down by Lagonis. Team 1 take round one, and it is their advantage. What? And through the attackers, Dez. Now then, I'm not sure if Rogue have spotted him out or not, but this could be dangerous. They haven't, Dez. Rips manages to get the opener onto Lagonis, but it's immediately traded back as Levy just skulking away in the map there, keeps himself undercover. Rogue were obviously confident that they had him picked up. They thought that that stage one clearance was done and that they were coming in and able to start looking outside, but absolutely not. Rips, however, finding himself a second off the rappel.
In both rounds so far, we've seen the entry kill come in, and within a second or two later, the kill is traded back elsewhere on the map. So it's not
apply some pressure towards Cocktail.
So weird.
Like you say, there's just absolutely no attention to Piano. Neskin gets an important kill onto Rips, but once again, KDS shut down with little impact in the round. Prano's got an opportunity to do what he's done all stage, Dez. He's getting that diffuser down. Rogue, we know, on the attack, very objective focus. But here comes Levy. He gets one. Can he find two? He makes the challenge, but does not find the man with the pre-fire. Prano now left to sit right smack bang on top of that diffuser. Beautiful nitro takes Leon down to a fraction, finished off by Levy. It's all up to Prano, Dez. He's one versus two.
Oh, he's got one. One versus one for Prano. Got so many plants down in this competition so far, and now has got a clutch out of 1v1. It's him versus Levy, the flanker of hell, who has done so much damage in this round already. Up comes Prano. Levy, pros don't fake. Is he going to come off? Yes, he is. Does he go for the gunfight? And he's got the kill. It's a quad in the round, and he gets the defuse. Rogue, for the second round in a row, gets so close, but are yet so far.
Trying to hold them off. He's got a cam on him, Dez. They've not spotted the black eye cam outside of the main door. That's going to be an opener for Levy onto Leon. They know where they are, Dez. Every single one of them. This information is just being fed in, and they are absolutely just utilizing this Valkyrie cam for all it is worth. Five versus one, halfway into the round. Rogue, you're going to have to.
Is a basically impossible task against Team 1. So why not use this as kind of a unofficial tack pause? Have a conversation, because three rounds have now gone against them. Three times, they've been stung by what feels like silly little mistakes, and they need.
Dropped into Red Stairs now. They were also. This is what we said we might see out of Rogue, Dez. Spotting an opportunity and going for it. They've rushed into sight. Aces 1, Aces 2, Aces 3. Dez flies in with a triple kill and rips Team 1 asunder in round four, and this is what Rogue needed. This is the energy. This is what's going to drive them forward. Prano might not even have time to get this diffuser down. As it happens, he will. Alamau gets one and absolutely nothing more as Rogue, they turn up the heat.
That round.
Moving towards that bottom floor. They've done great work upstairs. They need to make sure now that it doesn't stall out.
They're taking about a minute here on the top floor, longer than arguably they might need to. Just fearful that there is a member of Team 1 still present, where drones may well give them the answer. They've got six still on side. It's not like they're short of information, Ace, but not strictly playing behind it. They've dropped round for reading. They've found themselves one. Rips, watching for the half stairs flank to come up. Still a couple of members of Team 1 holding down to the south. A couple of kills fly in, but they're traded back just as soon. They've got no way in. The door is smoked off. You've got to move now, boys, and they're down with the diffuser. Two are down on the deck, and Rogue lose to the clock. Again, too much time on that top floor being invested.
what they
animation.
Hear the sound. Out comes the Nitro. One, two, and they get it. The double team play Nitro works perfectly. Neskin absolutely nails Rips with the second. He's breathing a sigh of relief, Dez. He gets away from the first, but then in his face comes the next, and there's nothing that he...
Right, again, 90 seconds in the round. No control of Piano yet established. They're still clearing out picks, so they've got rid of the Goyo shield that was there, but now they've got to worry about the castle barricade that's set up on the cigar door. They've managed to send the man back, and Ace is on the white window. Normally, Leon, who would play there. It's now Ace is finding that kill to push one back into 4v4, but the clock is not great. Levy finds one. Leon's down as Neskin inside a cigar shop finds another, and again, Team 1 has just rebuffed Rogue at every single turn.
Just absolutely nothing that Rogue can do at the minute to get themselves into this one, Dez. I think the change of halves cannot come quickly enough for them. And the problem that they've got is now Team 1 are carrying a lot of momentum forward. Lagonis is going to find Prano before he can secure that kill onto Neskin. It's 4v1. Neskin is likely to stay down through the remainder, I would expect. They're not going to want to risk themselves too much trying to rescue him. Alamau gets the kill before they even need to think about it. 5-1 on the half.
Top floor control. And we see some teams that will only reinforce out towards the Far East. Aces, that's a cheeky start. You'll see some teams that defend out towards the Far East and just hold Bar and Cocktail and drop away after. Some will basically do it as if they're defending Bar and Cocktail and hold right up inside a bathroom.
Instead to challenge onto White Stairs. Couldn't come head to head with Leon, and Leon's well Leon's aware dead. That Leon's he's dead. There, but out comes the nade, makes Ooh. The challenge, loses his life. Great solo play from Alamau there, Dez. Just following that nade in, forcing the man to move and just putting everything in his favour. I don't think they know about Prano. Certainly doesn't know about Aces, though. Alamau getting a little bit aggressive on the White Stairs there. Shut down, crying fans. Neskin, 4v2 for Rogue now.
This is the trouble you're going to face, right? Is when Rogue want to get aggressive against Windows by running around the map like lunatics, they will get away with it in some instances. It's a good first defense coming out. Lagonis trying to work his way up white here. Currently set at about the halfway mark. And has got two players around in the pulse, no doubt feeding information back that Lagonis is pushing up, or at least I bloody hope so. There we go. Crying finding one. One man left alive, sat on site. It's KDS, dug in behind the bookcase. Has got to do it all against three members of Rogue.
I said that they needed something special out of KDS today. There's more of a contribution, and this could certainly be a start as he gets himself one in the 1v4. Unlikely that he's going to finish this one off, I would imagine, but...
Going to see him on the left.
There's 50 seconds left to go.
There we
go. Shut down from behind there. Rips finding his last man. Rogue getting their first defensive round, and that's going to do absolute wonders for this Rogue side.
Now at least Team 1 are aware of his presence. But the barbed wire on side, he can't quite be rushed. Going to push him forward, finds the swing onto KDS, and down he goes.
Great start from Crying there, managing to use that information to his advantage. And I'm a little bit disappointed with Team Wanders. It was something that they managed to take advantage of, was cameras being left in place.
It's so interesting because very commonly we'll see on this site takers, the attackers, that you'd start from the west and work inwards. That has not been bothered with by Team 1. They've gone entirely from below, but Rogue have adapted to suit. They've got a couple of players playing on the downstairs. They've got the Valkyrie playing tight here. Alamau down to about half HP. Pistol in hand, Leon comes out there with a Deagle on side. Can he find the kill? It's Knife City in here, but no one can get the kill. Levy swings up and finds it back while Ace is elsewhere, brings down Lagonis. Things are balanced. Crying, going for the swing. Levy finding the kills, and I tell you what, 13-3 is not a bad scoreline. The quarterfinal, Ace.
Team 1 really do just keep fighting, don't they? They never give up. The support for Alamau there in that gunfight with Leon was fantastic. 2v3 now. Rips taking damage. Team 1, they're scrambling, Dez. They don't really have glass.
It's going to be a big White Stairs push here. I wasn't quite sure what Alamau was hoping to do from below because they couldn't really push up from there. Gets tagged. Ace is finding Levy. Rips the closer. Rogue find round 8. And I've got to say it, both teams looking equally messy on the attacking.
Ace on Cafe to find. Bring the IQ then, because they are punishing you right now.
Ooh!
However, talking of punishment, Dez.
Of course, it's Levy doing it as well. 14-4, nice. Looking at how things are shaped up, I agree with you, because after the last round, I saw the Yokais and the Valk. I thought, okay, surely now Team 1 realised that Rogue is doubling down on this information game and they bring along the IQ. But it wasn't to be a thing. The yellow ping coming in, Leon with a golden opportunity to find a kill, but couldn't quite connect his shots. That'll be the first and last time he gets a chance to get a kill out of that white door this round.
Alamo right now is all the way down on bottom. Flores looks to make the challenge onto Leon and gets him. I'm not sure that Rogue are aware of his presence there, and that is again Leon losing out in that battle. I can count in my head at least three times now that he's come head to head with Alamo, and whether Alamo's needed support or not, Leon's ended up dead on the back of it. And again,
away with that. Team One should have that covered every single time, or at the very least a drone there, but it wasn't present. Prano finding Alamo. A 3v3 with health bars basically even across both sides here, Tim. But Levy the God himself, he's still alive and kicking.
Neskin just again sweeping.
Caught out by that drone once it starts going off, but it's got his way inside a utility. He could catch them out here. Lagonis finding one onto Prano, a 2v3. Rips and Aces with it all to do. Aces having a great game so far as well. They've got full control of the site. Rips finds one walking in. He's going to back away down in towards the first floor, but he can spring back up at the right time here. Lagonis, he's going on a hunt. What can they possibly find? They see one walk in. Aces finds another. Are they clutching this one out? It goes down to a 1v1. Surely no! Aces with the shotgun finds a 3k. Rogue finds around, it's 5-4. But if Alamo slips through, I start feeling very nervous.
Exactly that. It really is going to come down to potentially whether he gets seen or not. Now then, Levy, he's going to get taken down. Dez,
of course, it's fire jump
comes
out
on a big jump out. Out goes the Nitro. Essential that he gets shut down there. Alamo it is to get up on the rappel quickly, react and get that kill before Aces can get himself back inside. The Nitro that he threw out will not have any impact. Thank you, look.
Seconds, both teams at each other's throats in every single round. Leon with a nice swing onto Alamo shuts down the nook. The one factor that we thought could be very detrimental to Rogue in this round has now been removed.
And I said Leon needed to start winning some of those fights against Alamo and could not have picked a better time to do so. Coming in with a really impactful kill there in the round, swinging it back in Rogue's favour. 4v3, and Team One looking a little bit lost here. Dez crying catches Neskin out as he looks to get inside of Piano. And right now, Team One have zero map control. They have not moved any of these Rogue defenders along. Finally, they managed to get the kill onto Crying inside of Piano. Lagonis getting that one, taking some damage in the process. But Team One have still got an awful lot of work to do here. There's only a minute left to go. They're just about taking control over the top floor. They've got Nitros underneath them. This could be a little bit of a nightmare finish to round 10 for them.
Prano's like a piranha pit, just going fishing here as well, holding out the cardiac sensor, as you mentioned. Exposed through utility. They did it in the previous attack around this site. Didn't opt to go down through the utility drop and didn't manage to end up getting in the round. KDS though, finding one back. No way do Rogue throw this one away. Plant going down inside a reading. A temporary 2v1 ensues. Surely Rogue can swing in and get the kill here. No, they can't. KDS onto a double. Leon has got to do it all now. He's found himself rotated back around and is killed out. How on earth have Rogue thrown away a 4v2?
Team One played.
Wide play for the window, entirely east and below side take. Find a nice grenade onto Rips, who was sat inside a cocktail, and that'll put the jitters up the side of Rogue a little bit. We spoke about the Wamai ban from Team One not really being super impactful in the first half, because Team One, of course, being the team that banned it away, so therefore detrimental to themselves. In this half, they are abusing that. A good number of grenades being tossed around and a few kills being found.
Leon knows he needs to get himself out of dodge there. They'd spotted him, he'd taken his
shots, get seen
from
the window,
hit them, and he knew that explosives were going to follow. He does manage to dip away from them. This is something that I've seen the LATAM sides do on Cafe before. Get themselves into reading with a book and
Leon
just completely open up the cocktail floor and make it impossible for the defenders to hold from that side. But Rogue, they're doing pretty well at the minute, Dez. They've dug their heels in and they're waiting here, but Neskin finds Crying after he goes on the jump out and takes down Lagonis. 4v3, 15 seconds left to go, and it's now or never for Team One in this round. They need to get themselves established in a position to put this diffuser down. Prano's going to play a spoiler. He gets one, but traded out immediately. 5 seconds and no sign of that diffuser going down, but Alamo in the absolute last breath of the round starts to do it, but Leon is able to shut it down, and Rogue get what is the first of two essential rounds.
Leon played that cigar-style hold that we saw coming out of Team One. It's a little bit more reserved, but it's still another entry. Ace is absolutely on fire. He's found two in the round before finally being shut down. But the damage has been done. Inside 90 seconds, we've lost Alamo. We've lost Iana. We've lost 4 frag grenades critically here, Ace. Those aren't going to be available, and we've seen them get several vertical kills in this game.
That's it. The Terror drone going to be used to open the hatch up. He's not sinning. Neskin has not thoroughly drawn that out enough, and Crying is just home free here, Dez. He's lead prone. If Neskin goes in, this is going to be an absolute freebie for Crying. They're just waiting for that moment. He's shot out. Crying's just trying to time this right now. And what a moment that we have. I love these where we can see, but they can't. He sees his man. There you go. As easy as that from Crying. And that goes to show you the margins that we are playing with, Dez. Neskin's drone goes another foot forward, and that's it. He sees Crying lead prone. It's a different story. Four versus one now. Rogue finish it off, and we are going to overtime.
Of course, man holding just above him. I believe it's Leon on the Valkyrie. We spoke about the damage that a Nook could do if left unchecked. And here comes the jump out. Will he find one? Yes, he will. Does he find the second as well out towards the door? No, he doesn't. Gets traded out. That's good, because for Alamau now, he can step up uncontested. Unless someone backfills that spot on White Stairs, that barbed wire is all but useless.
Rips taking the kills from Piano Stage this time. It was Crying last time around, but the position is... Oh, no, sorry. It is Crying that's playing there. The kill came in from elsewhere. There was a crossfire that Rips has been able to...
Oh, he's got him.
Piano finds Alamau. Knock this time, Alamau, as he gets taken out at the top. A White Stairs 4v1. Rogue are running away with it, Dez. I dare say that Team 1, the mental has gone in this map.
It's the attacking side, Ace. They can defend, but can they attack? Apparently not. Neither team able to get much. We've seen two attacking round wins so far. And after this round, the way it concludes out, 11 defensive rounds. And we were fearful of this coming into the map, and it has come to light. You know, two of arguably the worst defending teams, two of the best attacking teams. Which one gives way on a map that's very... Okay, just style points for the spinning before he goes for the final shot. Very common spot on the bar where you'd look to C4 inside of Freezer itself to do some damage. But KDS finding Leon. A swing coming in. There's another one out of the front door. Making a double coming in for Alamau. Two huge kills and the third man left there. Alamau hits the deck, goes for another, finds a triple. He's been quiet for much of the game, but that's the way to keep your team in this. And it looks like round 15 is on the cards.
So, Dez, I just cannot believe what I'm watching in this game. Put Team 1 on defense all of a sudden. They light the map up and look like a different side than the one we've just seen for the last seven rounds. But the problem for them is going to come in this final round. Round 15 that it looks almost certain we are heading to at the minute.
What?
Oh, saying that, Bruno just goes absolutely wild. Gets himself one as he drops into Freezer. He does have a lot of time. He's got the diffuser in hand. He's got options. But the Yokai drones are not going to make life easy for him. Team 1 know exactly where he is. They've got cams on him. They're just going to force him to play here, Dez.
He gets that Yokai, that's the critical one, because now they're out of information. This is where Prano, if he plays this right, and again, he's got so much time, could find himself walking away as the winner. You got the three-way split on screen, which I love seeing, by the way. You can see everything going down in this two versus one. He needs to find one with a shotgun. One holding out towards bar, and he has an idea as to where he is. There's no joint push coming in. The bullets enough to give it away. Can't find it, and Levy finally waking back up from his slumber. Careers us through to round. Coming in, almost finding Leon, but unfortunately bouncing off the wall and not quite getting the line of sight. Here comes the swing. That's a critical kill. Leon with a shotgun on White brings down the man that could have made it happen. Alamau taken off the board, and you've got to start feeling nervy if you're a Team 1 fan.
Great step up from Leon there. He's lost that fight a couple of times on White Stairs. But when it counts, shotgun in hand, he rips the head off Alamau. Now then, Neskin gets in, finds a kill onto Crying. Back and forth we go. Four versus four, a minute and a half left to go. We've still got the Valkyrie of Aces established inside of Piano. I think he's just been forced out by that drone. So Team 1 continuing that process of trying to get that top floor control. They've still got Rips out in Cocktail. There's nearly 2 minutes wasted by Rogue here, and a good start from them defensively.
And they've got the white control, the thing that, you know, Team 1 have constantly fought over. This is one of the first times they've opted to try and push him mainly from the west. KDS, that is a huge kill, because now that's two kills they found in one versus ones against members of Rogue who are either out of position or simply unaware as to what's going on. They're bleeding members they shouldn't be, and Team 1 could fight their way back in.
Just a yellow ping coming out there onto the man playing in behind the bookcase in the corner of sight. Levy's going to send in the Rotero drone just to open up the soft wall into dining room here. We could see the majority of this final push coming from over on the train side. Aces, it's just attention is being split here. Dez, he knows he might be pushed from the top floor, so he's not watching reading door as much as he might like to. The nade going in will be unsuccessful. Prano with a nitro. Aces with a kill onto Lagonis. It's all going in the direction of Rogue. Somebody's going to have to do something about this for Team 1. 15 seconds left to go. Neskin, Levy, they're throwing everything they've got at it, but Leon from the White Stairs once again. This could be rogue. It's a matter of seconds here for Neskin, and shut down in a huge round from Leon Gids, finishing off the round for Rogue, finishing off the map, and that is going to be a big start for the European team.
Absolutely huge start. Yes, it was their map choice. Yes, Team 1, we're up 5-1, but Rogue fought their way back in.